Sketch the following graph and state the components. We need to state the domain, the range, and the asymptote. The first thing that you should notice is that your x, your variable, is the exponent. So therefore, this is going to be an exponential growth or an exponential decay. You want to see what is being raised to the power of x. In this case, is 1/4. If it's less than 1, we know it's going to be an exponential decay. Because as you multiply 1/4 by itself, it's 1/4 and gets smaller, 1/16, 1/64, and so on. The numbers get smaller and smaller and smaller. But let's just make a quick table. I'm plugging values for x, gives me values back for y. Now I'm plugging in 0. 1/4 to the 0 power is 1. Anything to the 0 power gives me 1. 0, 1. Then I'm plugging in 1. 1/4 to the first power is 1/4. So plugging in 1 gives me 1/4. And notice that this is going to be an exponential decay. And you can plug in a negative 1 if you want. It gives you a positive 4. But for now, we're just making a quick sketch. And this is my asymptote. Your domain. Your domain are your x values. So if I'm walking on the x-axis, I know there's a graph above me here, but will there be a graph if I walk all the way back? Yes, your graph continues slowly moving to the left, rising very quickly, but slowly moving to the left as well. So therefore, it will be from negative infinity all the way to positive infinity. Or we say that it's all real numbers. Your range. At what point do I start seeing a graph? I start seeing a graph at 0 all the way to positive infinity. So from 0 to positive infinity. Remember, your range are your y values. And your asymptote. Remember, your asymptote is this dashed line. It's a horizontal line, x, y. If it's a vertical line, it will be x equal to a number. If it's a horizontal line, it's y equal to a number. Very happy, very, very happy. In this case, this is a horizontal line, so therefore it will be y equal to a number. It's crossing the y-axis at 0, so it will be y equal to 0. And that's it.